Well, how many second chances do you give a serial killer?
Well, today, a man who called himself the Phantom 50 years ago when he murdered two little girls told the Arizona Clemency Board that he deserves not one second chance, but two. Our chief investigative reporter, Morgan Lowe, has been working this story for 2 years.
Morgan, what's with the 2 second chances?
Yeah, seen in Chris, William Huff got his first second chance 3 years ago when the Clemency Board released him from prison while he was serving 40 years to life. But in November, Huff's parole officer paid him a surprise visit and found an 8-year-old girl in his apartment. Today, Huff asked the Clemency Board to forget about that.
This is egregious. I hate the word egregious, but this is egregious.
That is how William Huff reacted, appearing in a TV monitor in front of the Clemency Board when it became clear he was not getting out of prison again.
I need an explanation why I've been in here 52 years on a 40 to life sentence.
52 years ago in Sierra Vista, Huff sent a letter to the police chief calling himself the Phantom. And he abducted and murdered two little girls, 7-year-old Cindy Cleland and 6-year-old Janelle Haynes. In 2016, he was released from prison on home arrest. We spotted him in a Tucson neighborhood. None of the neighbors knew what he had done.
That allegation is false.
Today, the now 67-year-old Huff and his attorney tried to explain that it was no big deal that Huff's parole officers found his girlfriend's 8-year-old niece in Huff's apartment.
There at least an ambiguity in the written release conditions.
His attorney argued that Huff did not need prior permission to be around children.
He's a wonderful man. He's not going to kill anybody. He's not going to hurt anybody. He won't even hurt anybody's feelings.
Huff's sister argued that he is not a threat.
I speak for the Huff family.
But Huff's brother, who called into the hearing, told the board he had concerns.
We asked him to do two things. One, tell us what happened and understand and apologize for what he put us through. He never did that.
Janelle Haynes' niece called in with a graphic reminder of what Huff did.
A 6-year-old and a 7-year-old were stabbed, strangled, eviscerated, you name it, hit over the head with a rock, and attempted rape.
And in the end, the board decided that Huff had violated a condition of his release by having the little girls spend the night, then trying to cover it up. They voted to revoke his home arrest and send him back to prison.
He was given his freedom, yet, from my perspective, he violated it.
And Morgan, watching that story, you have to wonder, why would the girlfriend bring her niece to Huff's home?
There was some indication today that she did not know what he was in prison for, so she may not have known that he murdered two little girls, although she now knows about it, and she was at the hearing today supporting him.
Wow, absolutely stunning. Chief Investigative Reporter Morgan Lowe, thank you. Now, if you want to see more of Morgan's investigations, including his original story on the Phantom, just download our AZ Family mobile app, or you can head to our free website, azfamily.com.